with DJing, did you, like you said, it didn't take that long, but you feel like it was a little rough?
No, it was rough. It was rough because, like I said, I was basically known for dance music and mixing. I used to play in bars and clubs. And
in the city?
No, in Jersey.
Okay.
And my father owned a bar too. So I would play at his bar. I played at my uncle's bar. I played at their friends' bars. I would play at weddings and all. But I was known for keeping the party going. You know what I'm saying? And my father, you know, he always used to say, "You good, but you ain't nothing but a big tape deck because you don't never say nothing. You just keep the music going all night. Nobody never gonna know it's you." So that's how I got my mic game up.
Okay.
So then I got my mic game up. But, you know, as far as hip hop was concerned, that was in the gyms and the YMCA and, whatever various gyms around the way that we had where we gave parties at the VFW. And, you know, I couldn't get in them parties. Like, I could get in, but they wouldn't let me get on the stage and do my thing. And I used to be coming to the guys trying to get down with them or whatever. And they'd be like, "Nah, shorty, you're not ready yet." Mm-hmm. And I'm like,
"You know, you think that because they felt like you didn't build your name up yet?"
Yeah, but the thing of it is I'm listening to what's going on. And I know I belong. Mm. So I know.
Yeah, once you get on them decks.
Listen, give me the opportunity. But, you know, I bought the guy around my house and I had my own equipment or whatever. But later on, the same guys, I guess whoever they was using for equipment or whatever, had backed out on them. And I came in with my system and they paid me. I would have got down with them for free. Me and Biz wanted to get down with them. They used to have 500 people in the YMCA.
Wait, so back
YWCA.
It up. So back it up. Obviously, Biz is your cousin.
Yeah.
How did yous connect? Like, because, you know, I got cousins, but I don't even talk to you anymore. Where the fuck you at, cousins? You know, but how
I don't like most of my cousins.
No?
No, like, I swear.
One of my cousins got some big-ass titties, but I don't see her no more.
Yo, I can't. You being extra Latin today?
Yeah. ¿Qué pasó, primo?
Looking at your cousins?
Yo, but, V, Biz is your cousin.
Yeah, in these times when you know you ready, right? And my uncle was a DJ, too. But he wouldn't let me get on the turntables before a certain time. Mm-hmm. Until he came to the house one day and he saw me practicing. He's like, "Yo, we got to bring you to Long Island." You know what I'm saying? Now, you know, Biz was staying in Long Island at the time. So,
okay. You
know, that's... But my uncle wouldn't let us get on equipment out there. You know, he's the big DJ.
Most definitely.
He got a crew.
Yeah.
He got rappers.
Hey, young boy. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Take your time.
Yeah, y'all can't... No. Y'all can't get on here. But it came a time when we could. But now around the way, my sister, Sharon, she's in the book... by the way, the symphony, everybody go get out and get that, djgoovy.com. She was the first visionary to even see that me and Biz needed to do it together. Mm. She said, "You and Biz should make a record." Now, this wasn't even a thought of mine's or ours, because making a record wasn't the thing for me. I was already, you know, DJing parties or whatever the case, but Biz's dream was to make a record. Mm-hmm. So he would be going down everywhere, beatboxing for people, rapping, doing whatever, getting in battles. Me, I would get in battles, but it would be MCs, I'd be DJing or whatever the case, and it would work out. But my man, DJ Cheese, mm-hmm. He was the number one DJ in the world at the time. Mm-hmm. You know, he had won the world, the New Music Seminar, he had won the world supremacy, DMC thing. And, Cheese came in and we were having a battle at the YWCA. And he was like, "Yo, V, this your equipment?" I'm like, "Yeah." He said, "Yo, that sound good. Bring it to the field." And when he say the field, that's Plainfield, New Jersey.
Okay.
And I said, "Now, this is the number one DJ world, not the round the way.
Right.
The world." He say, "V, let's do this. Let's do it." Now, in my mind, if the number one DJ in the world sees something in me, why the guys around my way don't see the same thing?
But they hate us.
You know? And now I go out to Plainfield, and me and Cheese start rocking parties together. So I'm, like, opening up for him, and I got the equipment. So we start giving parties. So he comes in and closes. So now, you know, if you know anything about Cheese DJing, he DJ with turntables on the same side, mm-hmm. on the left-hand side. I can DJ with the turntables on anyway. So I hook the turntables up, DJ his way. And, you know, so when he come in, it's a smooth transition. He got the drum machine, so the parties used to be electric. So now Biz comes to the parties. Now we got, like, me, Cheese, Biz, we in the party. We tearing these parties up. And we started making a name for ourselves. So now we start moving to New Brunswick and Asbury Park and going around and doing
Jersey.
Things. Jersey, baby, Jersey. And the name starts getting up. Now, Biz is still making a name for himself in New York. He's moving around. He's doing everything. Now, he gets down with Shan. Mm-hmm. They do the thing called the 1-2.
Yep.
This was like a record, but it was a tape at the time. Mm-hmm. It's you imagining them playing it on the radio, but it's not. It's live from Roseland. Biz beatboxing for Shan. So it's the 1-2. And Biz was getting large off of that. So, all right. Boom. We like, yeah. Biz like, yo, we gonna be stars. Watch. We gonna be stars. We gonna be stars. Now, we looking at Biz like, yeah, all right. Because, you know, one thing that we didn't get into just now, me, Kane, and Swan.
And yo, hold up. Without going off track.
Yeah.
What the fuck is T.J. Swan?
He's around, man. He's managing groups, and he has a transportation company, too.
Really?
Yeah.
Like a accessoride for old people?
I don't know. He said he got trucks, and, you know, they ride people. I don't know. Yeah, I haven't rode in one, so I can't tell you.
Okay.
But
Shout out to TJ.
You know, last time I talked to him, that's what he told me. He had a transportation thing rolling. That's what it is.
Okay. So you said Biz and TJ.
He
and...
told us all we was going to be stars, but now we rocking loosely around New York, New Jersey, Long Island, whatever we doing, what we doing. And it just started picking up. And then you started seeing, you know, the work that you've been putting in is starting to pay off. Mm. Because now it's about being prepared. Because now we getting opportunities now. So now we got a 45-minute show and we ain't got no records. Mm. We get on after anybody. As long as you let us get on the stage. We don't care who got on, who's getting on. We doing what we doing, but we was getting a little chump change here, there, you know, promoters beating us for the money at the end of the night and all these funny stories. And
yo, you gotta, nobody fucking put those promoters in the trunk or something?
Nah, you gotta understand. We was young.
Yeah.
We teenagers.
Yeah.
We out here, we running around. We just trying to make a name for ourselves. It ain't too much to want to fight about, you know. You want to fight, but the promoter got away. All right, yeah.